guess what? Your best self is not going to start in 2024. It is going to start right now, right here, today, in November 2023.
Welcome to the Permission Slip Podcast, where I, empowerment coach, mindset expert, and holistic nutritionist, Carmen Olin, share with you the tools, conversations, and resources you need to write your own permission slip, take massive action, and become obsessed with your own life. Let's get started.
Hello, friends, and welcome back to the Permission Slip Podcast. I'm excited and enthusiastic about the end of 2023 and the beginning of 2024. And so that is why this episode is starting a new series called Best Self 2024. Because guess what? Your best self is not going to start in 2024. It is going to start right now, right here, today, in November 2023. So in this episode, we're going to talk about, I'm going to peel back the curtain of our permission slip community, which of course, like, you could join anytime because it is a free community that you can join. And every month we do challenges, we host devotionals, I share recipes, tips, things about clean beauty, clean eating, mindset, journaling, getting over limiting beliefs, and so much more. And this month, we are actually rebuilding or making our foundation of daily health rituals to take care of ourselves, like making it super strong. Because all of us in the community know that we can only reach our purpose and our calling and our dreams and our goals to the level that our body can take it. So I'm going to peel back the curtain and share with you a little bit about what we're doing, but you can always join us. There's a link in the show notes to join our permission slip community. Or if you head over to my Instagram, there's a link in my bio there as well. And of course, any questions that you have about any of this, shoot me a DM. I'm always in there. I'm always checking. I'm the one that personally answers all of that for you. And then next week, we're actually going to talk about the three R's that are required. Do you like what I did there? The three R's that are required to get to the next level in your life, your business, your health, your relationships, and more, because we all want that. And why I'm doing these episodes at the end of 2023 is because I just don't want you to say, like, fuck it right now, and then end 2023 not feeling good. Our goal each day should always be feeling good. And so we want to do whatever we can to feel that way. So let's go ahead and dive into how can you really build this foundation of taking care of yourself. And it starts with my four pillars. And I have been shouting these from the rooftops ever since. Well, before actually, what I was going to say, ever since I forgot them on live TV when I was on the news one time a number of years ago. But no, I've been talking about these for a while because they are so important, and they are protecting your energy, practicing daily movement, nourishing your body, and taking time to slow down each day. I used to always say slow the fuck down each day, primarily because I was speaking to myself, primarily because I always like to be on the go. I'm always working on no longer chronically activating my nervous system and being so high vibe, go, go, go energy all the time. I want to be like a peaceful, high vibe, go energy that gives herself permission to rest. That's where I'm at. So let me dive into each one of these areas. And what I would love for you to take away, what my hope, what my intention is for this podcast episode, for this series of Best Self 2024, is that you're able to take at least one of these things away, try it out, and implement it into your life. Because we are making a commitment right here at the end of 2023. We are just no longer consuming information. We're no longer consuming. We're being a creator in our life. And we are going to implement and integrate the things that we think are best for us in this season of our life. And that's what I want you to do with something from this podcast. So tag me on your Instagram stories with what you're taking away and you're trying to help build your foundation. So let me dive into each one of these areas. I'm going to give you some examples, and this is going to be short and sweet. So let's talk about protecting your energy. Protecting your energy is all about what I said, feeling good each and every day. Because as busy, ambitious women, we often take on too much. We don't fully express our feelings, and we are way too hard on ourselves, leaving us feeling unfulfilled and burnt out. And daily health rituals in this area will be things like asking for help, sharing how you're feeling out loud, even if it's quote unquote like a bad feeling or a negative feeling. That is the number one way that you can get out of anxiety and overwhelm and fear and doubt if you speak it out loud to somebody else. Believe me, it works. You can start taking your power back. Other things that you might do is in this area of protecting your energy is removing a commitment from your calendar that is no longer in alignment with who you are, with that best self 2024 that you know that you are on the inside that you're working towards. Another thing is setting unbreakable mean time. Often we'll put things on the calendar, but we schedule over them. We extend our time that we're working on a project over the things that we're supposed to be doing for ourselves. So think of any other appointment you would make unbreakable, like an important doctor's appointment, and make this unbreakable appointment for yourself. Asking for help is truly a superpower. What about intentionally starting your day and not starting it rushed? When you go to sleep, you wake up in the morning. Tomorrow, I'm going to be intentional about not rushing. What do I need to do in the evening to set myself up for that? Or maybe setting a boundary. Many of us set boundaries, but guess what? We allow people to break them. And so we're not keeping those commitments to ourselves, setting a boundary and keeping it. Or maybe saying no to something you really want to say no to that you would normally say yes to because you're a people pleaser. How did I come up with all of these? Because at some point in my life, I've done this, or one of my clients, or we talk about this in Flow Academy too. And if you have talked about Flow Academy before, oh my goodness, it is like this cohort of students. It is amazing. So Flow Academy is my signature coaching methodology that I teach to leaders, coaches, and entrepreneurs in a group coaching program called Flow Academy. It's 18 weeks. It's super comprehensive. You learn it all first for yourself. Turn the mirror back on yourself first so that you can teach it to your teams, your clients, become a holistic life coach and join my coaching community too. So that's a side note. Other things that you can do to protect your energy are scheduling white space, which means instead of doing back-to-back appointments every hour, you're scheduling 30 minutes or an hour in between where you have nothing scheduled. If you do this consistently each and every day, what happens is when you have an emergency or you have that fire drill that you know that you are going to have each and every day, you have the capacity to deal with it without it draining your energy. You can stay high vibe so that when you go home to the people you care about most, you have the energy for it because you've scheduled your day as such. What an idea, right? Wouldn't that be amazing? So that's protecting your energy. The next is nourishing your body. There's a lot to this, but it's all about what you're consuming and the things that your body truly needs. Water and nutrients. This is found in whole foods and good old H2O. And so daily health rituals in this area will be cooking and eating real food recipes. So instead of using processed packaged things, use real single ingredients foods, quality meats, vegetables, fruits, nuts, seeds, whole grains, that sort of thing. Maybe it's focusing on drinking at least 75 ounces of water per day or more. Maybe you're focused on eating a pound of vegetables per day. That sounds like a lot, but if you have a good sized vegetable serving at least three of your meals, you're going to be able to get that in. Maybe it's trying a new recipe, or even better, trying a new recipe with someone else that you love that's a healthy recipe and sharing a meal together. Maybe it's fasting for 12 to 14 hours. Okay, ladies, listen up. You don't need to be fasting really any longer than that. It puts too much stress on your body. But during this 12 to 14 hours, which 8 of it, you could be sleeping. So if you do this after dinner and then before your first meal the next day, autophagy, like it happens in your body where you have cell turnover. So your cells are like renewing themselves and you're going to feel better. I don't think you need to fast every single day, but throw that in maybe once or twice a week and see how it might change things for you. Lastly, in this area, something else that you could do is listening to your body after you eat, so you can really understand the foods that are good for you and the amounts of foods that are good for you. For example, I noticed that if I eat potatoes, I love it and it feels really good. If I overeat potatoes, it doesn't feel good. So nourishing your body is number two. Number three is practicing daily movement. And it's all about moving your body every day. Do you ever notice at 3 p.m. or have you ever heard about the 3 p.m. slump? Yeah, the 3 p.m. slump, what that is you've been sitting down way too long. Our bodies are energetic bodies. They're meant to move. So it's not that you need more coffee or you need more food or you need more energy. The energy is already inside of you. So if you take a quick break and you do move around a little bit, you're going to get energy, especially if you go outside. Now, some days you might feel like an intense, sweaty workout, and other days you might feel like stretching and a walk. The goal is simply to move every day as much as possible and listen to your body. So daily health rituals in this area might be setting a goal for a certain number of steps each day, or setting a goal to simply walk a mile each day. What about walking 10 minutes after lunch or 10 minutes after dinner each day? Not only will this help your body with digestion, it'll actually help slow the blood sugar curve. And so it's going to help you process your foods a little bit better and not store excess fat, which is kind of cool, right? What about trying a new workout, or even better, getting a workout buddy and trying it that way? Or so many of us know what to do in this area and we don't do it, and we need accountability. So hire a personal trainer. Making an investment like that in yourself is so important. Or sign up for a class that you are committed to and you know that you can build community at. I loved when our kids were in school, specifically our daughter was in middle school and our son was in high school, and he and I did CrossFit together. That was so fun. It was community, and him and I went together and I loved it. Other things that you could do is committing to stretching while watching your favorite show at nighttime, right? Instead of just sitting on the couch, do something that's good for your body. Or maybe foam rolling for 15 minutes after your workouts on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Because if you're anything like me, I'm still like a culprit of not warming up, not stretching, and not foam rolling as much as possible. You know, my friend Jeremy Scott, check out his podcast and his fitness app. He is like the best. He is like daily mobility and he is committed. Maybe that's like my best self 2024, what I need to be focusing on right now in this. I think we've just uncovered mine. I hope you've uncovered something so far, because we only have one more area, and that is slowing down. So slowing down could possibly be the most important foundational component of health rituals that you can work on. It's about letting go of the need to be constantly doing, consuming, or achieving, and turning inward. I'm going to say that again, because for so many of us, society and we ourselves have put so much pressure on ourselves, and it's been ingrained in us that we must always be doing or achieving, and we've made it part of our self-worth. So it's letting go of the need to having to be consistently doing, consuming, or achieving, and taking the time to slow down and turn inward. What does that mean to turn inward? It's time to think. One of the most, like the craziest, but most often things that people in Flow Academy or my clients come to me and tell me is this: I don't really even have time to think. And I challenge them on writing their dream day. And it's challenging for them to dream up things because they haven't had time to sit down, to use discernment, to dream, to vision, to plan in a really long time. So different things that you could do to slow down during the day is, hey, what if you just laid down for 15 minutes? Even if you weren't going to take a nap, you just rested your body. This is something I started doing a number of years ago. I'm not really a napper, but I love a good 15-minute, 20-minute lay down and rest. I feel so rejuvenated afterwards. Or heck, what if every now and then spontaneously just take the afternoon off and just know that not everything has to be done today and it doesn't all have to be done today and you can start again tomorrow. I also love inquiry journaling. Now, here's a little challenge that I gave at my last Conversations with Carmen, which are my in-person meetups I'm doing across the country. If you want me to come to your local city, please let me know, because these conversations are intimate, they are juicy, they are vulnerable, they are revealing, they are transformational. But I gave this challenge for 30 days, and I love, love, love that so many of the women took me up on it. But at the end of the night, to journal on these three questions, start a new journal, and at the end of the 30 days, you'll review your journal. But the questions are, what gave me energy and enthusiasm today? What drained my energy and enthusiasm today? And then what did I learn about myself today? And then I love that my friend and community member of the Permission Slip community, Jenny Worley, she added, and what am I grateful for today? I love that last question. She added that one in. So those are the questions. And inquiry journaling is just, again, creating the space to turn inward, time to think, time to reflect. Other things that you could do would be meditation, would be breath work. Get on YouTube and Google yoga nidra. It's not yoga. It's a meditation. You will love it, love it, love it. I like a really quick 3, 4, 5 breath. And what that is sitting comfortably, spine straight, so head and neck in alignment. It could be like crisscross on the floor, in a chair like I am right now, feet flat on the floor. And then just start deepening your breath. Roll your neck a little bit, pull your shoulders down, take your tongue from the roof of your mouth, and then breathe in through your nose for a count of 3. Hold at the top for a count of 4. And then breathe out your mouth for a count of 5. Now, what this is doing is this is going to take you out of that chronic nervous system activation that we're in so often, that fight or flight. And it's going to put you back into your parasympathetic nervous system, that some people call it rest and digest. I like to call it stay and play. Basically, it's calming your body, because when you're breathing longer for your out breath than you are for your inhale, it's actually stimulating your vagus nerve, which is helping you calm your body. So you could try that, maybe do that a handful of times, or even just do a 10-minute midday check-in. What was my intention for the day? How did I want to feel? And how am I feeling now? And then take 10 deep breaths. There's so many things that you can do. Often we think that we don't have time for it, but you have to make time for it. You have to make time for daily health rituals to take care of yourself, to check in with yourself, if you want to reach that best self 2024 that we're talking about. You have to start building the foundation now. You don't have to do all of these things that I mentioned, but pick one or two. Pick one and start doing it. Collect evidence how it works for you. Tweak it if you need to, but notice how you are feeling, because the goal of these daily health rituals and the goal of having this foundation is feeling good each day. When we feel good each day, we can show up as our best self. We can make decisions as our best self, which means we keep our commitments to ourselves, which means we can show up for other people in a bigger, bolder, more impactful way. And we can really keep that commitment. If you are joining me, if you've taken that commitment of joining me to be the one to show the world how truly great life can be, this is it right here. It starts with this foundation of taking care of yourself. So I know that you took something away from this podcast, and I know that you are no longer just consuming information. You are actually taking the information that you are learning, this information, this knowledge, and you are turning it into wisdom, because after you end this podcast, you are going to take action and integrate and implement it into your life. And I can't wait to hear from you on what you are doing. So tag me on your Instagram stories at Carmen Olin, and I will see you next week for the 3 R's that are required to uplevel your life, business, health, relationships, and more at the end of 2023 into 2024. Thanks for listening.